The Eastern West Virginia Community Foundation was established in 1995 to serve the citizens of the Eastern Panhandle of our great state of West Virginia. My name is Michael Walton. I'm the Executive Director of the Eastern West Virginia Community Foundation, and this is our uncommon story. Eastern West Virginia Community Foundation is located in the Caperton Station Suites, which is an old hotel that's been renovated and restored into offices right in downtown Martinsburg. The hotel was one of the first hotels that was built at a train station in America. And during the Civil War, it was not burned and destroyed like so many of the buildings in Martinsburg were, and served as a hotel for many, many years, and then was abandoned until about the late 1990s and restored in 2000. And it's a beautiful facility. We share the space with about seven other nonprofit organizations. We were established in 1995 by a group of businessmen and women who wanted to create endowed funds to support favorite charities and award scholarships. And Doug Roach, who was one of the owners of Roach Oil Company, was elected as the first president. And he and the board members ran the foundation for the first 6 years. They started it without any endowment at all. The first donor stepped up, and it was a fellow named George Hancock. And he created an endowed scholarship fund with a $100,000 gift in memory of his wife, who had passed away. She had been a kindergarten teacher, so this scholarship benefits students who are heading off to college, and we've awarded that scholarship every year since then. We now have $30 million in assets, 245 endowed funds, and we work with over 40 nonprofit organizations in the community by providing grants and technical support to those nonprofits. One of my favorite things that we do at the Eastern West Virginia Community Foundation is we award mini grants to teachers. And these are just grants of up to $500. You could give $500 to anybody in America. No one would be more appreciative than a teacher, and no one would be able to do more with $500. On the other end of the spectrum, Randy Smith is a former sheriff of Berkeley County, won a $79 million Powerball lottery. He provided the Community Foundation with a $5.9 million donation. Since 2010, we've awarded about $4 million in grants from that gift, including a $3.3 million grant to the Martinsburg-Berkeley County Parks and Recreation, which used the money to build a beautiful recreation center in South Berkeley County. It's built on the property of the Musselman High School, so it serves the purpose of providing a great gym space for the high school and middle school, but also for the community as well. I believe that the reason the individuals who created the foundation in the first place really wanted to have that feeling of community, and they wanted to be able to make a difference, not only during their lifetime, but long after they're gone. Looking back over the past 25 years, the Community Foundation has really done a remarkable job serving the nonprofit organizations that serve the people of the Eastern Panhandle of West Virginia. The mission continues to be the same. We are here to serve the people of West Virginia and make it a better place to live and work.